Hey guys, Derek Dirnberger here with The Break TV. Thanks for tuning into the channel. And as you already know from the title, we're gonna mount a scope today. And it's how I do it. I'm not saying it's the perfect way to mount a scope. I'm not saying it's the only way to mount a scope, but it's how I do it. And I've had success with it over the years. So I thought I'd share that with you. We'll go through the tools and supplies that I use to mount a scope. We'll go through the processes I take to secure it, level it, balance it, eye relief, all those things. So let's get into it. So first let's talk about the rifle. I've got a Browning X-Bolt Speed in 6.8 Western, and this is the new OVIX camo that Browning released this year. The specs on this rifle has an overall length of 44 inches. The weight of this bear gun is 6 pounds, 9 ounces. We've got a 24 inch barrel with the 6.8 Western, and it has a 7.5 inch twist rate on the barrel. The barrel and receiver is a smoked bronze Cerakote finish. We've got an adjustable trigger of 3 to 5 pounds, factory set at 4 pounds, which I won't adjust the weight on this gun. All my hunting rifles, I leave them at the factory setting at 4 pounds. They seem to be fine. I've got a couple of target rifles in the max long range that I do adjust down to the lowest setting, so they're about 3 pounds. We've got a detachable magazine with a capacity of 3 shells in it. One other thing, we've got a muzzle brake on the end of this. Now this is removable, and you can put just the thread protector on it for hunting purposes, so it's not nearly as loud, which I will probably do with this gun. Those are just some quick specs on the rifle itself. But let's get into the scope mounts. Now there are a lot of options. You've got a Picatinny rail base that you can mount on here, Weaver style bases, and then you have the rings that mount on top of that. A lot of different options, aluminum, steel. You can go to browning.com and check out their options, but today for this rifle, I'm gonna use the integrated scope mounts from Browning. Essentially what this is a ring and base combo. They're all just one piece, so I've got two of them. So each ring here, two rings for a scope, obviously, but each ring has a base on it, so that will attach directly to the receiver of the rifle here. So that's what we're using. And then for the scope today, we're using a Leupold, and this is the VX-6 3-18x44mm objective. So it's got a 30mm tube, and this one is the MOA. All right, so let's get into the tools that I use to mount my scope. So the first thing is you'll need a gun vise. This is a Tipton gun vise and has a lot of adjustability. I like it, it works well for me. And then you'll also need, I use a lot of levels. So the first one is just a standard carpenter level, and I use this one to make sure my gun vise is level before I even start the process, which I already did on this one. And then we have levels for the scope mounting process. We've got, this is a Wheeler, what is it? The reticle leveling system, the professional reticle leveling system. So I'll use that, and we'll get into how we use this one in just a minute. And then I also have this scope mounting kit from Wheeler, which has another couple levels in there, and then some tools that we'll use. Now, one of the most important tools inside this whole kit is a torque wrench, because you definitely do not want to over tighten any of the screws on this rifle, whether it's the rings that you're in the scope base that you're mounting to the rifle, or over tightening the rings holding the scope in place. So torque wrench is very important, and we'll talk about that more here in a second when we get to that point. Now, another tool that I use, it's called the Level Right Pro from Real Avid, and we'll get into that here in just a second, but it's not 100% necessary, but I've got OCD when it comes to leveling out my scope, so this is another tool that I use, and I'll show you that in a minute. Okay, now supplies that you'll need. I use some rubbing alcohol, and I use this to clean the rings before I mount my scope, and we've just got some little shotgun cleaning patches, the large cleaning patches that I'll use with the alcohol to rub that on there. I use some Loctite and this is just the blue. I guess it's the removable. So I use that when I'm on all my screws that I'm mounting to the gun and the scope rings. That is important. And I guess that's about it on the supply. So now let's get into the process. All right, so first thing when you're mounting your scope, you're gonna take the bolt out. You wanna get that out of there to make sure that there's no possibility of it being loaded and an accident happens. So we take that bolt out, we'll set that down there. Just go ahead and take that magazine out as well, so we know we've got a clear rifle here that we're working with. All right, so the first thing I wanna do, we're gonna take these protectors off and we're gonna mount these rings on here. Now you'll notice the bases on these rings. So they're a little bit different in curvature, and that's because this receiver is curved differently. So the flatter ring will go on the rear and it'll match up that perfect. And the more curved ring here will go on the front of the receiver. Now you also notice that the ring is offset to one side here. So depending on your eye relief, you can turn these either way. Doesn't matter. They'll fit either way on there. Depending on your eye relief and where the adjustments on your scope fall, you can mount these either way. So generally for me, I typically turn them like that to where I can slide the scope back as far as possible. So let's get these mounted on here. Before I do that, here's a case where I'm gonna clean the top of this receiver with my alcohol, and I'll just wipe it off. That'll get any oil and dust that might be on the receiver here. All right, so now this is the rear one. Now we're gonna use a torque wrench to tighten these bases on here, but I'm gonna use the wrench that came with my mounts. This little star key wrench that came with my mounts to start them. All right, and the reason is I do not want to cross thread these. That torque wrench is a little heavy and you really can't feel what's going on. So, you know, it's lefty loosey, righty tighty when you're doing this, but instead of just automatically just putting my screw in there and just tightening it down, I will get the bolt in there, the screw in there, and I will turn it backwards like I'm loosening it. And that makes sure that I'm getting the threads right. I'm not cross threading it. So as you turn it backwards, you will hear a click and feel it. There it was. So then I know that my threads are lined up, and then I will just start to tighten it down. That's a really good practice to make sure that you don't cross thread these base screws as you're mounting them. So yeah, just a little dab of Loctite on there. And we're sticking it in there in the hole. They're cut perfectly line up. Now I'm gonna turn it backwards like I'm loosening it until I hear that click, and then I know my threads are lined up, and then I can start to tighten it. And I just get it started until it stops. I'm not tightening it, I'm just snugging it, if that makes sense. Get in there, turn it backwards. Hear the click, all right. Get it snug. Okay, got all of them in there. Now I'm gonna snug everyone down. Again, this is just snug. I'm not tightening these until I get my torque wrench on here. This is the most important part, is not over tightening your bases to this rifle. So that's where this torque wrench is a necessity. We're gonna set this to 18 inch pounds, which is the recommended setting by Browning. That should be right there. All right, so what that will do, this torque wrench will, as you tighten this, when it hits that 18 pounds per inch pounds, it'll just kind of roll over so it won't over tighten it. and we're gonna do this at an X pattern. So we'll tighten this until we hear it click. There we go. We're set. There we go. There we go. There we go. Perfect. 18 inch pounds. Our base is set to our rifle. All right, so we've got it secured to the rifle. The base is at 18 inch pounds per base. Now I'm going to take this rubbing alcohol again and another cotton patch, and I'm just going to clean all this Loctite out of the inside of our rings here. Our bases are secure to the rifle, so now we're going to level this gun. I'm just going to kind of snug it up here on my vise lightly. All right, it's fairly secure here. Now when the levels come into play, and we're just going to put this level on the scope base here, and we're going to make sure that we get it level. And you do that by a number of adjustments on here. We've got the adjustments down here on this particular vise. We can make adjustments inside these clamps by tightening it and positioning these rubber clamps one way or another. All right, I'm looking at that level, and I'm also checking the level on the gun. And I'm gonna place another one of my levels on the receiver here, and to make sure, and I'm making sure that I'm not touching any part of the stock. There's a little bit of a flat piece here, and that is level. So we're good there. Leveling this way is not essential, but nevertheless, I still like to do it, and we're good that way too. All right, now, to make sure that we maintain that level, because we're gonna have to take this one off the scope bases, we're gonna put this one on the front of the barrel. So what we have here is, it's kind of a clamp system. We just loosen this. We're gonna slide this over the end of the barrel, and we're gonna match it up level to this level. Okay, we're just clamping this on here tight. We're gonna get it close. Now we'll just micro adjust this barrel level to match this level. Bubbles level there on the flat surface, and now we've set this barrel level. It's clamped down tight, so now we know that this is perfectly level on the barrel. We could actually remove this one if we wanted to, but we'll leave it on there for now because it's not in the way. All right, so now I got the scope out. The very first thing I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna clean it again with my rubbing alcohol and one of these cotton patches. I'm gonna clean the tube where it is gonna set into these rings here. So I'll just clean the whole tube there. And then we'll dry it off as well. Now we'll go ahead and set this thing in here. I'm gonna take my rings. I'm gonna clean these as well, the insides of these. All right, so now I'm just gonna snug up my top rings here so we can make some adjustments on our scope to make sure it is level. I'm gonna go ahead and put some Loctite on these. And then once again, we're gonna do that like we're loosening it, that backward until we hear that click, and then we'll just kind of start screwing those in. Just get them started. Turn it backwards to hear that click. Now we know that they're not cross-threaded. So we're just gonna get these snug to where our scope is somewhat solid in there, where it doesn't move real easily, just so we can, but we can still make adjustments on it. Now when you're tightening these rings, you want about the same amount of gap on each side of them. So again, don't just tighten one side down. It's the X bolt, so I'll go in the X pattern. I'll tighten, you know, the right front, then go to the back left, then go to the front left, and then the back right. So I'm tightening them in an X bolt in an X pattern. So think of that, X bolt, X pattern, tightening these. Just gonna tighten them a little bit. Just getting them snug, but still be able to adjust the scope. Now, I'm going to just snug it a little bit to where it doesn't move, because we're gonna take it out of this vise and I'm gonna check my eye relief. I'm leaving these levels on, I'm gonna take this one off. I'm leaving that level on there so when I replace the gun, I know I can just make it level and level that bubble right there. Not adjusting that, but just adjust the gun. All right. Okay, so when I'm checking eye relief, I want this thing on the maximum power. So we're going up to 18 on this one. This is a 3x18 VX6. And I wanna make sure that I'm setting up here how I'd normally shoulder the gun, and I'm making sure I've got the full view of the scope in here. Okay, I need to slide that scope back just a tiny bit. So we're gonna make that adjustment here. Oops. I'm not worried about leveling everything just yet, because I'm gonna make this adjustment and we'll put it back in there. Probably gonna be it right there. All right, just gonna snug it again to make sure my eye relief is good. Okay, that is pretty solid. All right, now I'm gonna get this gun back to level. I know that eye relief back and forth, front to back, the scope is positioned nicely. So now I'm going to set this gun level again. Now again, this is why we put that level on the front here, so we can easily get this thing back to level. Perfect. I'm gonna put this level on top here. Again, I'm matching up this level to all three of these. So if that's still square, that's still square, balanced, we're good. And I'm matching this one up to the same way. And that is level. That level matches that level. All right, now I can snug this thing down again. Now all the while I'm doing this, I'm making sure that I'm still level. All right, so one other thing here, again, why you wanna go in an X pattern. If you only tighten one side of this ring, not only will your gapping be wrong on the rings here, but as you cinch one side down, it pulls this scope to one side or the other. So it's very crucial that you just tighten a little bit at a time, one side at a time, and again, I'm gonna use a torque wrench on this. So I'm just kind of getting it finger snug with this Allen, this wrench that came with it, this little star key that came with it. That will be enough to make it, to hold it there. So, all right. Now, this is where, so before I would just stop at this. I would make sure this level matches the level of the gun, the scope level matches the level of the gun by putting this level here on top of this turret. But again, I'm OCD. I want to make sure that everything is perfectly level, that I've done everything possible. So this is where this Level Right Pro comes into play. Let's take a look at this. All right, so the Level Right Pro, we have two pieces to this. We've got a bracket that has a light in it, and this we will put onto the front of the gun. It will cast a beam of light through the scope, and we've got this grid that we'll put on the other end here. We'll level this grid, and what we can check is to make sure that our reticle is perfectly level to the leveled grid. But again, before we can do that, we have to make sure that our gun is level in the vise, which it is, because we checked that earlier, right? Three different levels we checked that. So we've got that level. Now we're just to the point where we're going to double and triple check everything. We're gonna cast this beam of light through our scope and make sure that we are perfectly level. So this is how the Level Right Pro works. You can see that beam of light cast through, and you can see the scope reticle there that is level to the leveled grid. I've got, there's a little bubble level on top of that grid. It's perfectly level. The reticle is level to that grid. My gun is level in the vise. Now I know that my scope is perfectly level in the gun. Now it's just time to tighten this scope down, cinch the deal. Again, I'm checking level one more time. Barrel level is still good. That's the one we set earlier. We're still good, and we're level on top of here. Now it's time to the torque wrench. And again, 18 inch pounds on these rings as well, as recommended on the back of this label that I pulled out of the scope ring box. Base torque is 18 inch pounds. Ring cap torque, 18 inch pounds. They're both the same. And it's still set on 18 inch pounds. So here we go. We're gonna go in an X pattern. Now, you have to make sure that you tighten it a little bit at a time, because every time you tighten it, it wants to twist and torque this scope on here. So I'm just going a little bit at a time in an X pattern. All right, now I'm gonna jump to the front rings, do the same process. Again, I haven't hit that 18 inch pounds yet because it hasn't torqued over. But I'm just doing it slow and steady. Now the other thing I'm checking here, I'm making sure that my gapping is good on both sides of these rings, that they're about the same. It looks pretty good. That one looks good also. All right, let's just keep cinching them down. Again, checking level after every little quarter turn that I make here. Still looking good, still looking pretty good, actually. If it does get off a little bit, like if you torque one side and it pulls it one way, then just loosen it back up ever so slightly and go to the other side and tighten that side. And that will pull it back into place. Still good, all right. I'm gonna go back here to the back again, and now we're gonna get to the torque part. We've made enough fine adjustments now that we're pretty set in here. Again, just checking. There we go, that one turned over. That one turned over. Good there. All right, back one's tight. It's turned over. Boom. Checking level one more time. We are perfectly level, and that is how I mount my scopes. I'm gonna do a follow-up video on how I break in a gun and sight it in. So there is a break-in process. So we'll cover that in the next video. We're gonna break in and sight in this gun right here and get it ready for my bear hunt coming up in just about a month away from now. So hey, if you like this video, hit that like button. Leave in the comments anything that you think I missed, things that you do as you mount scopes, or if you have any questions on the process here, maybe something I didn't cover that I overlooked within the process, or didn't cover that well, that you may have misunderstood. So yeah, leave a comment and be sure to hit that subscribe button. It really helps me out. And that's it for today. Tune in, that sight in video will be coming here in the next couple few weeks, hopefully. So be looking for that one, and we'll show you how to break in and sight in a rifle. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you next time.